He was friends with all the judges. That's what the detective told me.
Not
all. When I first talked to him, the first criminal investigation was like, you know, John Wayne Macho, I'm going to nail him, blah, blah, blah. And then a few months later, he had done some investigation, found out how connected he was, and he didn't sound so intrepid. But I don't live here, and I don't know who these people are. I think it made it easier for me, because I don't know who's friends with who, and I just cared about getting help for the victims.
Yes, and the other thing that comes from this is that you talk to a lot of friends.
Louder.
You talk to a lot of friends in your New York neighborhood and friendships. And they all said, yes, you have to do something.
Yeah, they weren't helping me. I was on doing it alone. So.
Wow, we all need cheerleaders.
Yeah.
But you did it anyway.
I've never been so frightened. I think one of the most frightening things was to call the police. I probably dialed and slammed down the phone about four times. It was just shocking to me that I was so afraid. I didn't think I would be.
I think it's changing so many lives.
Yeah, it
changed.
And
it's great.
Yeah. And that way she gives herself credit. Because absolutely. You got my son on the phone to tell me and my husband.
Yes, yeah, says Steve didn't, the police flew. And actually, yes, because they interviewed Steve on the phone in September 2002, and then we heard nothing for 2 months. And Steve was, it opened, it just sort of, he felt gutted emotionally, and then we didn't hear anything, and I was really afraid to call the cops. I thought is there a handbook, how to deal with cops? Do you wait a month? Am I not supposed to initiate? This is one thing, I always live in a world that plays by the rules, and I just don't. There was a dating book at the time called The Rules. Any of you here? Something stupid. Stupid about, don't call a guy first. And I thought it was something like, don't call a cop, after the investigation starts. And I didn't. But I did call the cop again. I said, what's up? Steve's in a lot of emotional pain. And he goes, well, he's friends with all the judges, and he's really connected. And I said, but, could you just call Steve and check up on him? And then the next day, they decided to fly Steve out to... I guess it was like, I'm about 10 years older than
right, you were the one that put him on the phone and you said to me, I didn't know who you were. I'm with your son, he has something to tell you. So,
Jerry and I used to do undercover work for Ed Montgomery, tremendous investigative reporter. And this ties into people being well connected. There was a school board member, I won't mention the city or anything, that had raped a young girl a number of times when he took her to some place where she was getting an award. Ed had all the details. And what Ed would do, if the newspaper would not print it and the examiner would not print it, because this member was very well connected in the cities, he was very in demand. And his title was always, his speaking title was always The Unprinted Story.
Oh.
And he would go to the, what's that big club, Commonwealth Club. Once a year or more, he would go to the Commonwealth Club and he would tell the unprinted story.
God, he's a great
and
guy.
Even after, at the Commonwealth Club, that he told the story, nothing happened to that man.
I was just going to ask. There were a lot of professionals, let's say, who were in contact with these boys over the course of their molestations.
Well, I decided once the search warrant, I sort of reverted that. Instead of being a citizen, now that the cops were looking for victims, I decided to look into Ayres' background in Boston. And by the way, I want to say that what police officers said, this doesn't happen very often. It doesn't happen every day, but it happens more than you think. And just because someone's a doctor with an Ivy League education, there are two guys I know along the train at the same place as Ayre did in Boston. And one of them was there when he was there, were busted for the same thing. Harvard, Yale. There are a lot of good child psychiatrists out there, but there are ones that... like the priests and rabbis, or but anyway, I decided to cold call Ayres' former partners, not knowing whether they were friends with him, you know, I guess I wanted to keep the police on their toes. There's nothing to stop me from looking for victims, too, and to do my own parallel thing. And if I found something that I thought would be helpful to their case, I would turn it over. And one of his partners is now dead. He died actually a few months ago, Dr. Hugh Weidelhuber. He died in a motorcycle accident, and he's a very chatty guy, and he didn't hang up on me, and turns out he wasn't that friendly with Ayres, and he was a former partner. And as I'm talking to him, he said, you know, come to think of it, I inherited a patient from Ayres in the 70s, and his father told me that his son was very uncomfortable getting all these physicals. And I think maybe something happened. And then I talked to Dr. Weidelhuber a few months later, and he remembered more, that he had confronted Ayres. He goes, why are you giving that child these physicals? And Ayres said, oh, I was trained to do that in Boston at a place called Judge Baker Guidance Center. Well, I had already found in cases it's going to happen, I had gone to that medical library and I looked up directories from 1960 and 61, and I wrote down the names of people he had trained with, and I actually found four doctors who did. And I said, were you trained to give physicals? They said, no, we never did that. It was to, you know, there was an on-site pediatrics unit at the place, and they never touched, and one of the guys who became head of the place said, that's crazy, we never touched the kids. And I actually found two men and one woman who were patients there in 60, 61. They had different psychiatrists, but they were never touched by their, they never got a physical from them. So I turned that over to the cops. But when Ayres was arrested, I was asked by the San Mateo Citizens Review Panel to write up some findings. And what started happening is that I started to hear a trickle and then got a regular flow that medical professionals knew or suspected that Ayres was doing this and didn't report him as they're mandated to. Now, this came from lawyers, and then I talked to a therapist who had, in 94, 95, had a juvenile who was, she thought, wow, he's getting physical. She went to Children's Services, and she was alarmed, and Children's Services said, nothing we can do, he's a doctor. I'm like, but I find that, and some parents knew that their kids were getting physicals, they knew about the presence, and they think, that's strange, but, you know, you've got to, just because he's a doctor, you've got to think, and my kid was examined by the pediatrician, and he found nothing wrong. Why would the doctor be touching it again? It doesn't make any sense. And what I found was that, I don't know what it was about Ayres, but that parents wouldn't ask what the physicals with the kids, what was entailed. I mean, if they had asked a few questions, you would have found out, like, this is wrong. But nobody did that.
But let's go back to the
mandated reporting. You could.
Just a brief overview. I'm not an expert in mandated reporting, what Jane Smithson is. But under California law, and in most states, there are certain levels of professionals who are required to report a suspicion molest or abuse, and many of you in this room are mandated reporters. That they include, obviously, physicians and psychiatrists, psychologists, teachers, anyone who works with children. Photo labs are mandated reporters.
Is a lawyer is a mandate?
No, lawyers are not mandated reporters.
So what?
Bear that in mind. So what my question was going to be, if there were suspicions that were being raised in mandated reporters, if they had reported it, do you think there would have been a different outcome?
Well, someone here in the audience did report Ayres in 87, and the police investigated, and there's another person here who told the police officer this is not normal, and two officers confronted Ayres, and I don't know what Ayres said to them. He goes, well, I was trained in Judge Baker, and of course they go, oh, he's a doctor, but, you know, so they didn't. I don't know. I think it depends on the year. I don't know what it was. Well, has anyone heard of Mel Levine, who's the well-known pediatrician? He's much more famous than Ayres is. He was on the front page of the New York Times in August. He is being sued by a number of boys for exactly the same thing. Do you know who he is?
Yeah. No, I just wanted to make it answer your question.